morning, students. Today, I will teach you how to draw the floral diagram of Brassica campestris. Brassica campestris belongs to family Cruciferae or Brassicaceae. So, first of all, this is the floral diagram for the Brassica campestris. Flower is bracteate, e-bracteolate, actinomorphic, bisexual, calyx 4, free, corolla 4, in form of cruciform. Now this cross it designates that corolla is present in cruciform, that is in form of a cross. And rostrum is 4 plus 2. This condition is called as the tetradynamous condition, where number of stamens are 6, 4 are longer and 2 are shorter, which is the characteristic feature of family Cruciferae. Gynoecium is bicarpellary syncarpus with superior ovule. So let's start first of all drawing from the calyx. Here we have drawn the mother axis. Number of calyx is 4. It is when number of calyx is 4, remember in this case, calyx is present in two valves. This anterior, posterior let me show you how to draw the calyx. In Brassica, number of calyx is 4, present in two valves. Anterior-posterior petal, it sepals, it forms outer valve, and lateral sepal, they form inner valve. So draw it like this. This sepals in outer valve and lateral sepal somewhat inwards. Next one is calyx. Calyx is 4, we have drawn it. Corolla, 4, in form of cruciform. So, to draw it in cruciform, first of all, and they are quite far apart from each other. So, we have drawn it like this. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Make it in form of cruciform, that is in form of a cross, and they are quite far away from each other. So this is our ball of corolla. Now, next one is androecium, 4 plus 2 condition, that is the tetradynamous condition. In order to draw the tetradynamous condition, remember 4 plus 2 condition, 4 stamens it forms outer one and 2 smaller stamens they will form slightly inwards. So here I am going to draw 4 large stamens, 1, 2, 3 and 4. It forms outer valve and make it slightly larger. And the lobes. Yeah, larger. And then inner wall. Slightly smaller. And remember they are alternate to each other. They are alternate with the petals. Then there is nectar sleeping disc. It's nectary at the base of the filaments. So this is how we will draw the androecium. 4 plus 2 condition, tetradynamous condition, 4 are longer, 2 are shorter. 4 are longer, 2 are shorter, 4, the longer stamen, they form the outer wall, and the smaller stamen, they form inner wall. One more thing, the longer stamen, they are extrodes, that is, anther lobe will face outward, and smaller stamen, they have the introdes. Make it like this, and in the larger stamen, make the anther lobe faces outward. Please, it's very important thing, so don't forget this point, how to draw the stamen. Next is, carpal, bicarpellary, syncarpal with parietal presentation. It's bicarpellary, syncarpal with parietal presentation. And one more thing, there is formation of a false septum which is called as replum. A false septum which is called as replum. Please make it slightly inward, slightly more inward. Yes, nice, okay. This is false septum replum, placentation is parietal. And there is also large nectar secreting. It's nectar secreting disc. As it belongs to discipulary, right? So discipulary means it will have the nectar secreting disc below the ovary. Now one more important thing is flower is bracteate. So make a bracket. Make a bracket. So this is your floral diagram of Brassica campestris. I'm going to explain it once again. Flower is bracteate, e-bracteolate, actinomorphic, bisexual, calyx 4-3, corolla 4-3, that is a polypetalous, it is polysepalous, corolla is free and present in form of cruciform. Cruciform means it is present in form of a cross. Androecium 4+2, tetradynamous condition. Dinosium, bicarpellary, syncarpus with parietal presentation. So first we have drawn the calyx, number is 4. Antero posterior sepal has formed the outer wall. Lateral sepal has formed inner wall, slightly inward. Calyx, this was the wall of calyx. Next is corolla, present in form of the crucifer, in form of the cross. That's why the family is cruciferi family. And they are far apart from each other. Then next is androecium 4+2 condition. 4 are larger stamen facing outwards, that is the extrodes. 2 smaller introdes having the nectar secreting disc at the base of the filament. Then gynoecium bicarpellary, syncarpal with parietal presentation. And there is a false septum which is called as replum. And on both sides of the, there is a prominent nectar secreting disc, and then there is a bracket. So this is how we draw the floral diagram of Brassica. Please see it carefully.